A nice discount from EVL Gaming.
Yep, and any other big EVL TV events we need to announce tonight, Jer? Before we get going? Nope, nothing going on right now. We're just waiting for playoffs and should be a good game. So here we go, watching off on the scout. Enigma playing it out and take it away, Seki.
Alright, well, pretty standard rollout. Combo going left side. See Enigma right here. He jumps up onto the house. Just looking over that bets, doesn't really see anything. Ooh, and a penetration kill from Chingu takes down Spyro and Bowser. That's not going to be very good, and Enigma's actually all the way behind. He's in JK spawn right now, but Carolina is pushing across this point right now. Does a decent amount of damage to Harblue, down to 50 health there. Spamfest goes down, cast a lot of frags going down for MTS. This is actually going in JK's favor right now, as Dill goes down on the front side coming out of that lower. This first mid went to JK, to everyone's surprise.
Yeah, Carolina, oh, here comes the bomb, so it might not be that way. No, he's going to be just fine here on the med. Yeah,
Remedy good, getting good shut down.
But yeah, the demo man, Carolina, got a lot of good pressure over onto safe side, able to spam out the medic and keep him way back. It looks like Harblue had to back at, oh yeah, I think he dropped because he's back at 10% here.
Harblue did go down, and now JK Valkyrie with that 100% uber advantage. Let's see if they pop it aggressive here. Maybe try to get Harblue again, but I don't know, MTS, they're known for their crazy plays, so they're actually just coming in right now, taking this ground. But ooh, Dill goes down to say. Jingu goes down, a lot of frags. Ooh, Harblue went down to a stab from Flintstone.
That's really good. That's a second drop here already for Harblue, so things are already looking a little bit dire.
JK looking really strong in this first round.
The thing about Asheville is that you can really, really hold mid once you have it. You just get sentry guns on the top. Ooh, nice air shot there by the soldier, though. So, Doman going down, trading, and Connor trading with him. So there we go. It's really easy to hold mid just because you can put sentry guns everywhere. You can hold on both boxes and you can be anywhere on this map. It's really hard to get in because of those little, what are they called, walkway ends with the shutters. They come up and down and they can be right outside.
Yep, and actually JK let MTS get a ton of captain there on the point before popping their uber in. Looks like they actually lost a fair amount of players, but Harblue did go down.
Oh my goodness.
And I think Valkyrie's going to get out of this, so that's pretty clean. I wouldn't say they're holding this because MTS are on the point now. But I'm pretty sure that that was a really good job, and they actually haven't finished the cap yet as Spamfest goes down. Enigma's in behind them right now, and Lemon Pulp went down. That's going to be a cap for MTS, but minute and a half advantage for JK, as well as about a 30% uber advantage on Valkyrie.
Wow, very good job from JK. They do make it a 90-second cap time for them, so that's a very long time. But look, already MTS being really aggressive, taking some early picks and really trying to push the cell.
This is the MTS we know, just being aggressive, taking every, like, meter of ground they can get. It's actually so many frags going down on MTS side. JK just pushing and dry pushing for free, and now Harblue did go down, so that's gonna be
beautiful snipe
from Akuma. Just getting that ambi headshot gets Valkyrie down at 80%. That's gonna make this at least even right now. Actually about a 15%, 20% advantage for Harblue.
Yeah, so, but I mean, they've still lost the point. They gotta get the point back. They only had a Pyro Ninja up. They're just now getting their spawns. They're coming back out, they're going through battlements, and it seems alright for them right now, but they gotta get on that point. It's very hard to take, and they might already be forced into an overtime situation here.
Yep, Giraffe's coming across the point right now, laying down the pressure onto the right side. Not managing to get any frags, but Harblue with 50% owner advantage. Remedy goes down to a snipe from Bowser. Connor goes down to an Ambassador headshot from Akuma. Chufro goes down. A lot of frags
going
down.
Look at this concave. Dill look at this comp gate by MTS. This is huge.
Yeah, look at this. There's just Giraffe's just playing that corner on point fantastically and getting all that cap time with a ton of frags going down. Harblue's at Uber right now, so they could pop this aggressively. Valkyrie's down 50%. Ooh, okay, sorry. I heard this bicycle there and I thought for a second that Harblue got stabbed. I was scared for a second.
Chingu going down to Jufro.
Yep.
They can potentially force here with the meta Harblue out here, and this will be the first Uber of the game for him.
Jufro
really
showing
far
his strength, getting two right there with Remedy and Katsi. Now putting
Spy
pressure on the point. I think MTS's combo is an under. Actually, no, that's just Spamfest with a mini sentry getting that shenanigan. They're holding on ramp, actually. A bit of an unorthodox hold, but they didn't. This is very unlike MTS, actually. They just let Valkyrie get that uber advantage back up. But, oh, so many frags going down for JK. That's all their combo, pretty much. Carolina's still up, but no Spyro and no Lemon Pulp. This uber's not going to get much. And with Katsi right
forced out
there,
the enemy uber.
Yep.
I think they're going to be able to wrap around. Oh my goodness, they're completely surrounded here in the tunnel now. MTS might actually end up going down here. No, they're actually totally good. They get the wrap-around from Enigma, who gets a triple kill with Spamfest on the other side. Really
big Valkyrie play did go down. And actually, something worth noting is that this is King of the Hill, so any trade that you have is in the favor of the team that does not have the point.
That's true. That wasn't just a trade, though. They also kept their medic alive, so Harblue still at 60%, about a 50% advantage. They actually traded Ubers and still have the point, so that's very, very good for them. It's actually back to even right now. About 50 seconds left on both sides. Soldier comes in, looking for a shot. Not able to find it. Dill is right there.
Yeah, this is a lot more like MTS, just with this sort of unorthodox but yet well-oiled hold, just managing to keep this ground, and when the ground is contested, they just respond really, really strongly.
Yeah, here comes some, very far forward Demo Man here. He actually stays alive. Pyro gets some good reflex off, keeps
Uber
him up
coming
there,
and
Uber comes
Valkyrie
through.
Down to 30 health, but she is, goes down. Enigma's doing work right now, as Tufro is the only one up. They pretty much wiped on that push.
That was a good wipe, and I think MTS going to come back from that terrible start to begin with and might end off the round here. There's 20 seconds remaining for them. They have a sentry gun in the safe zone now. They are actually going to be able to get the safe health back if they want. They got Sticky Spam up in front, and this aggressive hold might make it happen, but they're kind of a little bit out of position here. No, Medic and Heavy go back to point. NG, Scout, Demoman, Medic, they're all moving over to point here for JK. They're getting the corner
shots. Contesting this. They have the grump. They need to be putting this cap time to push it into overtime. Dill's caught in here. He should go down. Yes, he does. Lemon Pulp goes down, but actually the whole flank is in collapsed onto this blue combo right now for JK. That's so many people going down. Carolina goes down. Valkyrie goes down. There's still time left on the point. It's not over yet. Ooh, but with the Uber on point, that's going to be the round.
Yeah, that was a really, really good counter push by MTS there. They had the Enigma especially got like three kills there to get some cleanup in the end with just like six shots. It was really, really good. It bought them the time they needed it. The Soldier came back around and came out and spammed them out. So Remedy cleaning up on what Enigma started. And again, the flanks turned out to be dominant on this map.
Yep. Great job there by MTS taking the first round. But JK not uncontesting. They did a really fantastic job there. Pulled on their own. Remedy just bombing it immediately on the combo, getting pressure onto Chinga, but he goes down very fast.
Bowser, I'm watching Bowser Cram right now. He's not finding a lot of good shots. They do take out a sentry gun and
Jurassic goes down.
Out.
That's gonna hurt this whole mid. Dill goes down too. That's another mid win for JK, I gotta say. They're not winning these overall DM engagements, but these mid fights, they know how to play these mids.
Oh my goodness, Enigma almost is totally trapped down here in tunnel. He's got his pyro to back him up, but let's see if they can rotate around and get him out. No, it looks like Enigma is gonna be able to get out of here alive. He's gonna be about 10% down because he wasn't healing through all that. So they might be able to. Oh, stab comes out onto Medic. That's a drop. Huge play by Akuma. Glaceon. Harbor is going to be up on his Uber now. That's a super Uber advantage going over to MTS's way and should be the all clear to go.
Akuma turning the ties right there, just pulling that out. But yep,
huge
really great job.
Stab.
Akuma's been doing so much for his team. They do get this
really,
point
really
right
good.
Now. MTS does. Spamfest doing a great job holding aggressively on this mini sentry that covers the balcony side.
Look at this aggression. Enigma's just barreling down the mid choke point here. They find out. Oh, man.
Carolina
they
goes down. Katsi takes down Valkyrie with a nice flare.
Nice
they're
shot.
Pushing into spawn right now. This is the MTS I know. This is the MTS I remember.
This is what they want to do. They just want to hold them out. They don't want to give them any ground whatsoever. They want to show their dominance. They know they're a better team, and they're definitely like showing it right now. They have a Remedy hiding around the mid corner here. He's going to find an engineer any second now. Yep, one shot, two shot. Three shot makes him down. He might drop himself. Oh, he actually lived. Nope. Spam shot here. Good shot by Spyro to make that happen.
JK's combo has him inside right now. Taking back that ground that MTS so just forcefully tried to hold from them.
And now they have to defend against their own battlements. It's coming back around. Spam's coming over the top. Only the Demo Man's poking out.
Yeah, they
They're
actually came
out
from Shutter right now. And Spyro going down immediately. Carolina just got totally shut down and couldn't do any damage. And this is a total wraparound play. Valkyrie should be dead right now as she does go down to Enigma, just walking in right there.
Wow, and now it's a 40-second advantage here for MTS, and they have a super uber advantage again. The wraparound is too strong, and I think they keep pushing from one side or the other, and they can't take both at the same time. This is really not where you want to be right now.
Yeah, JK gonna have to step it up somehow. I'm gonna say that, I don't know, I haven't seen Bowser been doing too much, and this isn't a bad map for snipers by any standard. So
not the best, but oh, they forced out an Uber here. Heavy is just kind of derping around, staying alive. I think he's taking the health back. I'm not sure he got it. Nope, didn't.
Valkyrie goes. They're in. That was MTS with great advantage. Did Does TV career freeze for you?
Yep. Looks like it's a pause. Things are going out of control right now for JK, man. They had such a good start. They were looking so, so strong. And now MTS has gotten their aggressive game on. They are taking... When they can start being aggressive like this against you and your spawn, they can start taking advantages that you just don't play against. You've always played for mid. You always play around all the areas around mid. But when they're on your battlements, it's like when they have a Demoman, Heavy... Who's on the battlements right now? Demoman, Heavy, Soldier, Medic, Sniper, Engineer coming with a Sentry Gun, of course.
It's such a hard thing to push against. It's such a hard thing to push against. You don't. What do you have to do to force them off your battlements? You have to get your flank in and do enough damage to them to where they have to run off point and get into lower, which basically is really hard to do because you need to have a super strong flank.
Oh, is that why they're paused here?
Tactical pause. Alright, I like it.
I think it's interesting. I don't think I've ever seen somebody tactically pause before. I'm not sure I believe you either, Jir, but...
I don't know. Turbo Cup, what do you think that JK needs to do right now to pull this back?
Well, let's see. In their specific position right now, Flintstone, what is he running? Is he running Deadringer, or is he running...
He's running Deadringer, Spicicle, and Diamondback, which is an interesting choice, getting that critical hit after every stab and sap.
Yeah, I think he just wants to sap sentries, so he should come up, spamfest's sentry, do an aggressive decloak underneath them, and come up when his team's coming up. I don't think the spawns might necessarily allow for that, but I think that's their best chance right now for a spy pick of some sort to blow this wide open. On the core side, they need to come out, they need to rotate to mid if they know that they're all on the battlement side, which I think they should know that by this point. Mario's really, really far forward. He's got to back out and rotate over left side, probably. And then the whole combo's got to come through mid. The Demoman's got to get that angle right over the mid corridor, spam out over to the top, force them back with some good spam play, and then they can all rush forward through the mid shutter area. Take over with a heavy with a scout coming back rushing over the flank side. That would be the perfect positioning for them. Force MTS back after you get your spawns up. I don't see the spawn timers right now, so I don't know exactly how much time is on spawn.
Yeah, neither do I. Actually, something interesting I want to mention real quick is Chingu opting to run Jurati instead of the Razorback, which I've seen some snipers do it on King of the Hill. They can pull it off quite well, getting that extra damage in on the combo. Lets your flank do a lot more certainly in your demo. Your demos love Jurati, I'm just gonna tell you that right now. Getting that 80 damage sticky on the spam, gorgeous.
He's been stabbed out a little bit here, but especially since they're so far forwardly held and they've got a good height advantage here, he can throw that Jurati all over the place. And let's see what this scout does here. He pokes over battlements. They know they're there. Spy, what are you gonna do? Oh, he didn't get stabbed
Mario
out.
Do
century,
go
but... down. Yeah, right. He just goes down. That's really
JK just waiting for their spawns right now. HUDs are a little messed up right now. Please forgive us. Nothing we can do about it. So we don't really know how much time. I think it was about a minute left that MTS had on the point.
Yep, and I reloaded HUD here real quick, so looks like we got 50 seconds remaining here for MTS. We have a 50% advantage here for Harblue. Okay, Heavy's just going to run up the hill. Oh man, he gets just taken down easily with a snipe and a soldier pop. Soldier runs for it. Oh, they're just all over spawn. Demoman's, they're really, really far spread in MTS is right now. Okay, finally a nice stab coming through onto Chingo. Looks like Bowser going to be playing on the backside. He might actually he should just cap this. Force them back, and then everyone else can go forward. But nobody's in position to go forward. In fact, they're going the wrong way. They should have gone up battlements. Instead, they go over to safe side. Harblue's kind of stuck out here. Engineer can make the play. Engineer, make the play. Make the play, Engineer. He does. He gets the force out. Flies away to death.
Nice job.
They really needed
one thing
that.
I'm noticing that MTX is doing is their flank classes, notably Remedy and Enigma, are playing with their combo a lot, honestly. And actually, now JK is, pardon me for a second, as JK are coming in right now, I believe they have an uber advantage. Yeah, they do. They have almost a full uber advantage. Getting positioning out of the point here. It's just Dill and this mini sentry walking across point, but actually, the whole combo went down, and MTS is going to take that second round.
It just wasn't enough. They had Remedy on their backside. They weren't able to properly deal with him, and my goodness, look at Anubis' score right now, leading by far.
Oh, that's disgusting. Four dominations. That's not something you want to see. I'm actually going to credit that to Mario, so I'm not really doing that great of a job putting pressure on that high ground like an engineer should.
Yeah, we haven't seen too many sentries up front. Okay, now we do. We have a nice one up front here. It's not going to be dealt with. Okay, he does get dealt with. I think he might just be a little bit too aggressive with it, and then he just gets taken out too easily. Okay, they get a sniper advantage
Chingu
here
and
on JK.
Go down. Yeah, Connor is not up right now to pressure this. Valkyrie goes down to a headshot from Akuma.
Very far forward there. Kind of questionable, really.
Flintstone coming out of the shutter door. Does get spotted out by Dill. So now, full Uber advantage for MTS. My head is messed up a little bit, so I might be a bit slow on a few things. But Harley drops to Flintstone. That was beautiful.
Wow.
I think Connor jumped in. Connor jumped in and made Harblue surf a rocket, which distracted the whole combo and let Flintstone get in for free and stab Harblue. That was play of the century.
Play of the week, of the millennia, of the eon. That was, wow.
That was amazing. And SpamFest actually getting a little cocky right now, running level 3 centuries.
Oh, is he?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's building up in that shutter door. Building up
this
in that shutter door might be a tactical idea.
Oh, he already revealed it.
Valkyrie
level 1
here. Akuma. He gets 2 right now, Carolina and Mario.
Nice play there. There's a good surprise play, and it's going to keep them the point, actually, which is really big for them right now. You really want to capture the point every time you go on to Asheville. You don't ever want to get partial time like you would necessarily on like a lakeside.
Yeah, about 45 seconds advantage, almost a minute now. Connor just jumping right into Sticky. Giraffe has been doing a really solid job of getting in that spam, doing the damage he needs to, shutting down that ground.
I think Katsy's been, I'm not sure about Spicicle, because I think Katsy's just been doing a really good job of holding them back. Oh, there's just a huge Uber through the main shutter here. They're going to get everybody again. Scouts
yeah,
just Valkyrie
goes
for med.
Down.
Wow.
Harblue, more than any medic, knows the power of a scout during an Uber, which is honestly like winning them this game right now, because every Uber I see, he's flashing an Enigma, and Enigma is just getting these frags, putting damage into people that Valkyrie just doesn't have the time to flash.
Yeah, that's right. And now we got 5 people up again on the battlements. You got the heavy in the back to spam out anyone who does a big jump forward, like a soldier or a scout.
Yeah, and this is so hard to respond to. You have to basically wrap your whole team around them, and by the time you do that, they have enough time to respond to you and basically kill you. And now we have SpamFest actually putting up a sentry on here. Interesting choice, but I think it's actually gonna do a lot of work for them right now.
And look, they're dying around this corner because they just don't know how to play around it. I mean, I don't know how to play around it. They're just losing to it. Which is really, really bad place to be right now. This might change Asheville for a while. JK is a really good team, and they have to like force to respond to this, and they just don't know how. This is like very, very different for them.
Yeah, this is one. Oh, actually, Zuber's coming in right now. Valkyrie does pop it off.
Oh my goodness. He's getting controlled back by the pyro. He's not even getting much of a play here. He got a pyro and a spy. Spy's not even dead yet. Enigma backs out nicely, and there's 30 seconds remaining. This might
Spamfest
be
and the sentry
a
go
perfect
down.
Round, dude.
I don't know. JK's got a lot of frags right now. Giraffe, Chingu going down too. Spamfest down. But yeah, just Dill and Harblue with Enigma holding really strongly up on this point. They're basically wrapped around, but they're just JK are too afraid to walk onto that battlements and contest them.
Enigma again finds the pick. He jumps in, gets the one shot he needed and made it happen. Valkyrie goes down again. Enigma, I don't think, has died at all this round. He's at 70% Uber right. Oh, no, he's still alive. 75%. They're finding someone in the back, and that's a perfect round for MTS. Good half for them. My goodness, MTS is completely dominating right now.
Yeah, it just. I don't know. There's not a whole lot to say. They're just getting out DM'd, outplayed, and that forward hold on Bats is really, really strong. And I feel like JK, if they're winning these mids, so if they play more aggressive and get more frags, they can get these forward holds that MTS are holding on them, because they're honestly so hard to respond to.
Absolutely. I mean, I think it's just like, if you can get that forward hold, if you can get them to wipe and then get that forward and keep players of your own, get that forward hold, you are so far ahead at that point.
That's that is one argument I see that I can agree with on Coalplant over Asheville, is that lobby on Coalplant is much more open than it is on Asheville, and it makes things like forward holds on Bats a lot more easy to respond to.
That's absolutely true, dude. And I mean, we might just see it be a 4-0 here very quick. People are looking at stats right now. Has anyone got the stats pull it up? Seki, you got them up right now?
I do not. Okay.
Nope, that's okay. I don't think we really need to see anything. The story of the day is that Enigma is dominating.
Yeah, I don't think we've actually been giving enough credit to Giraffe. He's just tailing behind Enigma here on the scoreboard, and he's probably been putting out a lot of damage, a lot of frags, taking out a lot of those sentries.
Yep, that's true. Dill's been moving. Dill's been caught out a lot, so his like heavy points are a little bit lacking, but it doesn't matter. They're still mining all the picks.
Dill follows like in bait, Arthur's right? footsteps and likes playing on the flank. Which, I mean, this is Asheville, but he's not been doing that too much. Because most of the time the flank has been with his combo, and they're just waiting for JK to wrap around them. They're playing so tightly.
Yeah, they especially Enigma's basically been playing against another core. He's not been off on the flank very often. He is at the beginning, but he generally hasn't been, at least over the last round. I believe two rounds ago he made an amazing flank play and got like 3Ks. JK though still have record for best play of the game. So at least they got that go for them, right?
Yeah.
We should see that in the frag video pretty soon.
We actually do have logs right now posted in the chat right now. And very predictably, Enigma topping off the kills with 33 and 428 BPM. Like top four for kills right now is just Enigma, Remedy, Giraffe, and Akuma, which is pretty predictable. Actually, Akuma doing top, I believe, on the damage. Yeah,
he's made like
right
so
now.
Many ambi shots this game so far. It's kind of ridiculous. I think MTS taunting them a little bit. JK, I'm sure, is like going in the tank right now.
Mm-hmm.
This is similar to that other game we casted the other day, Seki, like a couple weeks ago.
Yeah.
Except that game seemed a little bit closer.
Did seem a little bit closer. So I don't know. Let's see if JK can pull a Dream Killers and come right back right now.
That would be sick. That'd be nice.
Just pulling four straight rounds out right now.
I think Asheville is not like the best for that. I think Asheville is not necessarily as good for the comeback. I think Viaduct's better at it, just because of the way the map works, and like he's dominating hold.
You're back here in the second half. Let's see. I'm gonna watch Spyro right now. He's putting out that flare. It's going straight beeline to that lower. That's one thing a lot of teams like to do, which is sort of odd, is just push your combo right through lower. Not a huge fan of it. He takes down Enigma right away. And with Akuma going down, that's going to be actually a surprising amount of pressure off of them. Connor goes down, so there goes some of their pressure. But again, just sort of doing the typical thing they've been doing and forcing MTS into this corner. Spamfest with that level 1 sentry right there. Giraffe goes down to Flintstone.
Ooh, nice.
Carolina goes down to Spamfest's Wrangler too, and actually gets Mario with that Lemon Pulp to Spamfest with this level 1 Wrangled sentry. Getting so much. And MTS, they just baited them on a point. Ooh, and Bowser gets horribly. That's going to be a big play.
That's
Chibi
really, really
goes down to Connor.
I'm not sure they can. Oh, they're doing their own version of this with the mini. Enigma cleans up on Bowser 5 here, but I think it's back to evensies, kind of, although there is a big uber advantage, but they're not playing it. Like, JK's staying really far back. They got to be aggressive, like, right
Enigma
now.
Enigma goes down again. This is a pretty back-and-forth mid, but there's a lot of players down on both sides. But I think that the players left up, as well as this 100% uber advantage for JK, are going to win them this out.
I'm wondering why are they not pushing with uber right now? Are they missing a player? Are they missing the demo?
Who hardly goes down again. I think they were afraid of Chingu's sniper lines, and with Chingu going down, their combo's just walking in, yeah. And
okay, Spy's here, though.
Again.
Spy's
this
on
is, yeah, this is a problem right now, because while Carolina doesn't have any stickies loaded, I'm like watching him spam stickies all over the place, and now he has to deal with Spamfest in the shutter too.
Yeah, he has a level 2 sentry gun in the shutter now, wrangling out, looking for snaps. Harblue.
Harblue has died. Harblue has consecutively died so many times.
Yeah, he's died like what, 4 or 5 times now.
Pretty
it's
much,
kind of ridiculous.
We're just now like getting into 45 seconds, maybe even a minute into the round, but JK's combo holding lower here, actually letting MTS get a little bit of time onto the point. But Carolina coming back and doing so much damage, taking out Katsy, getting those pipes, and doesn't manage to take down Dill.
Remedy actually found the scout, got a jump play off of it, but not able to get much off of it afterward.
Big uber advantage
comes
for JK
down
right now, but when Harpoon goes down again to Bowser, Dill and Giraffe go down. They're looking so much better right now, JKR.
This stab's all what they need right now. Oh, okay, they're sapping.
This
they're
is
sapping
JK's
stuff
round
now.
Right now.
Okay, this is good. Oh, they even had a teleport.
Ooh,
that explains
Akuma
everything.
Akuma gets Valkyrie in Carolina.
Wow, double stab in the back end. Throws it back in their favor for sure.
Oh, that was so disheartening. JK were on a roll right there and then just gets stabbed. It's actually Mario following a little bit after Spamfist putting that mini sentry up in the shutter. He does go down though.
I want to talk a little bit about what Spamfest is doing, which is that he's putting a teleporter in the backside. They've had better spawn times because of a teleporter, which he is like prioritized after the sentry. He's prioritizing it before the sentry gun. Oh no, it's right after the sentry gun, but he's like had level ones forever, and he has a teleporter that leads a little bit farther forward, and I think that's where they're getting their success from.
Really interesting.
They consistently have better stuff, and now like the spy is completely dealing with Spamfest now. So
yeah, JK
Clinton's
actually,
his job
JK,
make his life
they're fixing one thing I noticed from this last round, is that they were just playing sort of scared and letting MTS get those nice forward holds on them, and they're playing fairly aggressively right now as they're popping this Uber off into them. Actually, no, I'm sorry, that was MTS that popped the Uber. They were just getting their Uber now, and
Enemy
was in behind again, but Harlu goes down, Giraffe goes down, Spamfist and his gun, or it's just his gun go down, Akuma. Flintstone, I don't know.
Yeah, but Chingo's back up there looking
Chingo
for those
goes
snipe
down
plays.
To Bowser.
Never mind.
Bowser's turned it on this round.
Yeah, this game's going way better for JK right now.
Enigma goes down on the backside to Connor. Jufro getting pressured up right there by Remedy. It's actually Akuma's in on the combo. Can he get Valkyrie? Oh,
nope.
Akuma gets spotted. He's dead ringing out, I think, though. Giraffe goes down to Bowser. Yeah, this is JK's round for sure, and I think it can be attributed to Bowser just hitting those snipes a lot more consistently and making MTS afraid.
That's true, although, to be fair, Spamfest has, like, saved the round so many times. Katsy gets stabbed out, Remedy gets cleaned out. There's a nice stab onto Mario by the spy on the backside. Chingu takes out Connor.
Valkyrie just getting that Uber up right now, and although
they
are
in
a numbers disadvantage, they again have... is about to get his Uber up.
Yep,
Chingu
Uber's on both sides.
Bowser. Bowser's just so dominant.
You really want your soldier alive right now during these Uber engagements, because
Uber's
can clean
going
up
down
and
lower.
Go.
It's just Spyro and Valkyrie. Valkyrie's just backing off, and he's rotating up so to heal his Carolina, and Carolina does go down.
This medic's super dead now. That was
Bowser gets Harvlu once again.
Wow, Bowser needs to keep making these. These are just saving the round for them every time. If it wasn't for that, they'd be dead by now. These
I saw Mario had a nice surf there. He took a rocket and shutter and surfed it up to the stairs and onto that health pack.
I think because MTS was doing so well for the first couple rounds, Harblue's like movement is like a little predictable here. He's like not been like on his A game over it, and Bowser's making him pay for it.
Yep, Carolina peeking from that balcony. Combo just holding on balcony here. I'm not sure how I feel about this because there's a really open sniper line, and it's sort of hard to rotate against.
Yeah, that's true. And, we got Mario playing with the spot Akuma. Oh, okay, Akuma does go down, so this opens up a little bit of a map for them. Their blue side JK is over on the flank side. Oh, we got another level 2 sentry gun though. This might
small
be
small Uber advantage
with.
For MTS, about 40%, 30%, I believe, I'm sorry.
Oh, wow, Flintstone deals with Spamfest. There's no more sentry gun, so that's good. Valkyrie goes down.
This is typical MTS. Just baiting them in with some sort of advantage while they don't know about it, and then just basically wipe them, get the super forward hold. Chingu's in deep right now. Chingu's sitting in lobby. Chingu, what are you doing?
And again, I gotta point out this Spamfest teleporter. JK has no teleporter of their own. They haven't had one the entire game, and MTS just has better spawns because of it. They're already out here at mid while JK is sitting in battlements, when the reality is they should be, like, even Z right now.
Now, I know JK's a smart team, and they know that that Harblu plays Uber right now, and they know that they need to force him, but I think they're scared of MTS just taking a lot of ground once they do pop, because, again, Harblu knows how to get that scout, and he knows the importance of getting that scout in, and their combo just wiped on point, JK's did. And now time's evening up right now.
They spent the whole time trying to force MTS there. Oh, nice snipe onto Enigma though. Good pick by Bowser. He could make a play now by rotating over. They're gonna go under. I think they know this is game. They have
to
make it.
Yeah, JK gonna have to make a play now.
Oh, they find it. Spyro finds Harblu.
Oh,
he gets a double kill with
so
Bowser's
many frags.
Help. That's really really big. Sentry gun's out of position. There's like everyone on the point.
This is tense.
Could be it. This could be the return that they need. 20 seconds remaining. They've gotta go. Don't hold
mid,
JK.
They do have this teleporter. Chingu goes down. Dill is still not up yet. But Valkyrie did go down at some point. He went down to Akuma stat. So, JK without heal. 5 seconds. Can they hold on to it? Here come MTS.
Oh, Enigma goes down. Oh, they might get the demo man too. This heavy,
Carolina
this surprise heavy is going to get everyone. With the pyro on
Lemon
the backside,
pull.
Two kills.
Lemon pull sticking it out. Dill comes in. The spawns are better for MTS right now. So if this fight keeps going like it is, it's going to go in their favor.
It's really, really close. Bowser is still alive.
Too
well. A snipe.
Valkyrie's coming in onto the point. Come on.
Oh, I think that's it, dude. Double overtime for the 4-0 victory for MTS. Wow. And JK, they got their stuff together, but it was just too late.
Yeah, towards the end of that, they did realize what their mistakes were, but MTS just too strong. They showed their dominance. They showed their dominance, but JK definitely showed why they deserve to be top four.
We've seen that Sentry in Midshutter before, but we hadn't seen it for a while now. So I think nobody did it last season. So seeing it come back again felt like really good. Spamfest prioritized teleporters a lot, and it didn't seem like it did a lot, but it really does. When you can save like 2 or 3 seconds on your rollout every time, it's really, really big.
Mm-hmm. You do lose about 5 or 6 seconds, I believe, on your spawn disadvantage when you have the point. So forward teleporter really making up for that.
Absolutely. And yeah, good games, everyone. We've been having a good cast for you here. Seki, what's going on for the rest of the week here at EBL TV?
Oh, well, rest of the week. I don't believe there's anything happening in the world of ESEA playoffs, but this Sunday we do have a surprise coming up for you guys.
Ooh.
No surprise, we've been discussing it, been getting plans together. I don't want to spoil too much yet, but we got some plans for this, so we'll see how you guys enjoy that.
Alright, well, if you got nothing else to say for the rest of the night, I'm TurboCop.
I'm Seki.
This has been an EBL TV cast. See you guys next time.
Heart's racing and it's getting pretty hard to lights dance on both their faces. Your eyes, they sparkle bright. The beating of my heart draws closer, but my brain is losing sight. I don't wanna fall in love tonight. I don't wanna fall in love tonight. Take my hand.